Bill Gilmour is an exceptional young footballer, that is beyond doubt. After his first Premier League start for Chelsea, he was named Man of the Match. It was the same story in the Champions League and the FA Cup, and for Scotland at his summer's European Championship. Nothing fazes him, Andrew Robertson, Liverpool fullback and Scotland captain, said in June. That is why I believe he can have as many Scotland caps as he wants. He has got a huge future ahead of him, but the here and now is pretty good as well. Those at Chelsea are fully aware of Gilmour's talents. He ran games at youth level for the Blues and made the transition to senior football look effortless. Liverpool at home in the FA Cup? No problem. A visit of Everton in Premier League? No problem. Man City away, nothing to be overawed about. The problem that faced Gilmour at Stamford Bridge was those ahead of him in the pecking order, where World Cup winner and Ballon d'Or contender N'Golo Kanté, European Championship winner and Ballon d'Or contender Jorginho, and Mateo Kovacic, whose CV includes spells at Real Madrid and Inter Milan. Gilmour pushed hard during the second half of last season to force his way into the side, but only 5 appearances were offered to the young midfielder by Thomas Tuchel. It is why this summer the decision was taken for the 20-year-old to head out on loan. Tuchel felt it was the right call, having spoken to Gilmour. Tuchel said, "I love Billy in general. I always loved him," the Chelsea head coach said last month. Even when he wasn't in the full spotlight in the last half season, but he decided to go to have a bigger chance to play some minutes, that is important. Norwich City were the club chosen to take care of Gilmour for the 2021-2022 campaign. It appeared a shrewd decision, as Gilmour would secure minutes under Daniel Farke, a coach who worked closely with Tuchel at Borussia Dortmund and understood the 48-year-old methods. "I can't wait for the season ahead," Gilmour said after joining the newly promoted Canaries. "I have been looking forward to coming here, playing as much as possible and helping Norwich compete in the Premier League." Gilmour was impressive in the pre-season for Norwich, then came the hardest starts in the Premier League: Liverpool, Manchester City, Leicester City and Arsenal. The Scotland international played the opening 3 matches, which all ended in defeats. He watched on from the bench against Arsenal, but returned the following weekend against Watford. The match played on September 18 ended in a 3-1 defeat to Falkirk's side. Gilmour hasn't featured in top flight since a run of 5 matches since then. There is understandable concern among Chelsea supporters. It wasn't supposed to happen. Gilmour was supposed to play. That was an exception that swayed the Blues' decision to send the academy graduate to Carrow Road. Billy is a fantastic player, a fantastic human being, and of course, he wants to play each and every second, the Norwich boss said last month. "If you love football, you love Billy, because this guy is a baller. But he is also a young lad and we have to look after him. It's not always that easy for him, with the hype in his own country, with lots of praise for him. I think he has a good mindset and works hard on pitch. He has unbelievable potential." All good, right? But earlier in that press conference, Farke said this: "We are not here to develop players for other clubs. We are here to win points for this club." Well, it is not about Billy Gilmour, about Brendan Williams, unknown for Manchester United, Kenny Macklin or Timmy Pukki, who are our players. We just like to play with the players to win points. This is also the challenge our loan players want to have. It's not like they want to play just because we have loaned them and they want them, that is the parent club, to play many games. Big clubs like Manchester United and Chelsea do not want it easy for their players. The players want to be Manchester United, Chelsea or Tottenham players one day, so they need to face a challenge and step up to it. That school of thought was echoed by Tuchel earlier this week. The Chelsea head coach insisted he wasn't concerned about Gilmour's lack of football, although he did admit the loan could be ended in January if required. I spoke with Danny about Gilmour and I was happy to meet Billy around the match against Norwich Tuchel said. Sometimes this week and months arrive where the situation seems to be stuck or seems to not be going the right way. You have to hang in there, show your quality and help your team. That sharpens your character. It can be a big chapter in your career. That is the same for Billy. It is not the moment for me to give solutions for January or open talks to bring him back. Fakir's argument that it's not his job to develop other clubs' players has some merit. His job is only to do the best by Norwich, whether he's doing that at the moment or not.